Dosage calculations for nursing and pharmacy students are important part of their exams. So solving those dosage calculations in faster and accurate way require a good skills in problem solutions. So here in this video, I like to present you a simple techniques and tips how to solve them in faster way and simpler way. So let's start with this video. This video covers topics related to simple metric unit conversions, drug dosage calculations, drug dosage calculations based on body weight, and IV drip rate calculations and flow rate for infusion pumps. So first, let's start with the metric unit conversions. So the metric unit conversions can be solved by different methods. You can do it by simple direct ratio proportion methods or by using dimensional analysis methods. So here I like to give you simple techniques. How do you solve them by using dimensional analysis? So here are the commonly used metric units for liquids are teaspoonful, tablespoonful, and ounces. So 1 teaspoonful is equals 5 milliliters, 1 tablespoonful is 15 milliliters, and 1 ounce is 30 milliliters. So here let's take some samples to practice how to convert them into the metric units. So here 5 teaspoons have how many milliliters? So to solve those, I'll set up this dimension analysis like 5 teaspoonful and then 1 teaspoonful with 5 milliliters and cancel out teaspoonful, teaspoonful, and then multiply on the tops like 5 into 5 mils, and that is equals to 25 mils, and bottoms 1 in 1 is 1. So now you have 25 mils. That 5 teaspoonfuls are equals to 25 mils. Let's take another example. 3 ounce have how many milliliters? 3 ounce set up into the dimension analysis. So 1 ounce is equals to 30 mils. So cancel out ounce and ounce. So again, then next step, multiply top, that is 3 into 30 mils, that is equals to 90 mils, and multiply bottom ones, like 1 into 1, that's 1, so you will have 90 mils. So that 30 mils, 33 ounces equals to 90 mils. Let's do the other conversions of those liquids, like liters to milliliters conversions. Let's try one. 0.1 liters equals how many milliliters? So set up them into dimension analysis, 0.1 liters, and then 1 liter with 1,000 milliliters. So liters, liters cancels out, and then multiply 0.1 times 100,000, so it would be 100 mils. So another way to do that is can be simply multiply the liters to 1,000, that gives you milliliters. Or you can move these 3 digits from the decimal to the right side. Let's say if it's a 0.1, then move to the 3 digits, like 3 digits right side, 1 digit, 2 digits, and 3 digits. So that way you get a total 1,000 milliliters. So that's another simple way of solving those direct conversion from liters to milliliters. Let's try another example. 100 milliliters have how many liters? So set up into the dimension analysis, 100 milliliters and 1 liter with 1,000 milliliters. So mils cancels out, then multiply 100 times 1, that would be again, then 100 over 1,000, that gives you 0.100 liters. So another way to do them can be just simply dividing mils with 1000, that means you can also go move to the, from decimal to the three digits to the left side of the 0.1 from the 100 mils. Like if you move those three digits to the left side, one digit, two digits, and third from the decimal point, that gives you 0.1 or 0.1 liters, which is equals to 100 milliliters. So just for note, 1 deciliter equals to 100 milliliters. So next, another conversion factor is grams to milligrams. Let's take example, 500 milligrams have a how many grams? So to do that, let's set up the dimensional analysis, 50 milligrams, like 1 gram is with 1000 milligram. So milligrams and milligram cancels out, and then you have a 50 over 1000, that gives you 0.050 grams. Alternatively, you can also convert by multiplying grams with 1000, that gives you milligrams. So another one is, let's do the other way around, like grams to milligrams. So the grams, 0.2 grams set up into the dimension analysis. So 1 gram is with 1000 milligram. So now grams and grams cancels out, then you will have 200 milligrams. And this can be also done by alternatively the other method, by simply dividing milligrams by 1000, that gives you the grams as well. All right, so next we do have other conversion factors, that is 1 milligram equals 1000 micrograms. So how do we convert from milligram to 1000 micrograms? So let's take an example, 2 milligrams have how many micrograms? Set up into the dimension analysis, 2 milligram, and 1 milligram is with 1000 microgram. So milligram, milligram cancels out. So you have 2 into 1000, that gives you 2000 microgram. Alternatively, another method that can be done by simply multiplying 1000 to milligram, that gives you microgram, because 1 milligram equals 1000 micrograms. So the another method here, another example, like 50 microgram equals how many milligrams? So 50 micrograms, set up them into dimension analysis. So 1 milligram is with 1000 microgram. So then you microgram, microgram cancels out. Then 50 over 1000, that gives you 0.050 milligram. Also, you can do it by dividing with 1000 for milligram to get a microgram to the to make it milligram. So next, let's do how to calculate dosage calculations by using desired over half method. So desired and over half method is one of the most commonly and most effective way and faster way to solve for dose to be administered or dose to be given. So desired and over half and quantity. So that is, desired is dose that is ordered, and half like strength of the drug that is available or drug that is available on hand, and then quantity. Quantity would be amount or volume of the drug. So by using this simple technique, like desired over half method technique, you can easily calculate dose to be given. So that is, this is the commonly used method for simple and faster way to calculate the dosages for calculations. So let's take an example. Here you have an order for gravel, 25 milligram taken by mouth, oral. So the gravel is available into 50 milligram per tablet. So how many tablets would the nurse administer? So to solve them, let's put them into simple steps. Step one, determine what is given to you. That what is given to do is given to you is amount that is desired, that is 25 milligram. Like tablets you need for like desired dose is 25 milligram. And amount in hand is 50 milligram, whereas quantity here, 50 milligram is one tablet. So one tablet is a quantity. So now you plug in what you know into the formula, like dose over half and then quantity, that gives you this one. For example, this desired dose is 25 milligram, and then amount in hand is 50 milligram, and this is 50 milligram is for one tablet. That means if you cancel out milligram and milligram, then you will get half tablet or 0.5 tablet. So this for this order, nurse will administer half tablet. So let's take another example, that is order for 2.5 grams of IV daily, and available strength of the IV is comes in 1000 milligram per 2 milliliters. So now the question is, how much a nurse would administer to the patient for this given order? Again, you can do into simple steps. So determine step one, determine what is given to you. Given to you is amount desired is 2.5 grams, and then amount in hand is 1000 milligrams, and then obviously the quantity is for 2 mils. So now the step two is here require a simple conversion of the units. Because here given question amount desired is 2.5 grams. So what we have to do is step two, convert grams to milligrams. To do that, just set up the dimension analysis, 2.5 grams or 1 gram equals 1000 milligram, grams cancels out, so it gives you desired amount is 2500 milligram. Now step three, plug in what you know into the formula of desired over half method, like desired dose is 2500 milligram, and in hand is 1000 milligram, and the quantity is 2 mils. So now they cancel out milligram and milligram, and then you will get 5 mils. So for this given order, nurse would administer 5 mils to get 2.5 grams of IV dose. So let's take another example to utilizing dose over half method. So here order is for lorazepam, 4 milligram IV push. The hospital has 10 mils of vial in 2 milligrams per mil concentration. How much a nurse should administer to the patient? So let's set up into the step one. Step one, determine your givens, and that is amount desired is 4 milligram, and amount in hand is 2 milligram, which is 2 milligram per mil, and also quantity is for 1 mil. Remember, there can be mistake happen. Quantity is not a 10 mil. Quantity is a 1 mil. Because this vial is for 10 mil, but 10 mil contain 2 milligrams per mil. So now let's do the step two, plug in what you know into the formula, which is the dose over half and quantity. So you have dose is 4 milligram, that is, and drug amount on the hand is 2 milligram, and the quantity is 1 mil. So you cancel out milligram, milligram, and then you get 2 mils. So to get 4 milligrams of IV push, you have to draw 2 mils from this 10 mil vial to administer equivalent to 4 milligram of IV. Let's do the next question, that is a dose, that is calculating the dose weight-based calculations. So generally the body weight is given, and for specific dose, how much dose you require for that particular given body weight. So to do that one, simple, always require two-step method to calculate them. Step one, first calculate total required dose based on the body weight. And body weight generally taken here is per kg. So weight of the body is given in the kg, and dose order also have to be kgs. Kilograms. That means you have to first step, if it is not given in the kilograms, then you calculate convert them into kilogram. A lot of times body weight is given in the pounds. So therefore, are you required to change from pounds to the kilogram? That's a step one. Step two, then you plug in into the dose over half method, those numbers, it will give you the total dose for that particular body weight. Next, let's take an example, how to solve example question. The order is for methylprednisolone, 2 milligram per kg for a child weighing 60 pounds. And methylprednisolone is available as 500 milligram per 4 mL. How much should a nurse administer to the patient? So first step, convert pounds to kilogram, the body weight, because body weight is given in pounds. So it is important to change that to kilogram. So that can be done by using dimension analysis, 60 pound patient weight, and you have 2.2 pound per kg. So 1 kg with 2.2 pounds. So now cancel out pounds and pounds. So you will get 60 divided by 2.2. That gives you 27.2 kilogram. So the body weight here is 27.2 kilograms. The second step is calculate the dose for the weight. That means 4 milligram per kg. And then here, how many kgs body weight? 27.2. And then kgs and kgs cancels out. Multiply 4 milligram times 27.2. You get 108.8, but you can round up to 109, which is patient will receive 109 milligram. Then, once you know this, the dose for this particular weight, like 60 pounds weight, and then you third step is calculate the volume to be administered, and this can be done by using dose over half method. So to do this dose over half method, again, you have dose is 109 milligram and on hand is 500 milligram. That is for 4 mL. That means cancel out milligram, milligram, then you get 0.87 mils. So this is what the dose administered, 0.87 mils have to be withdrawn from this to administer 4 milligram per kg for 60 pound weight. Next, other type of questions that are commonly seen are intravenous drip rate calculations. And the unit for that is GTT per minute. GTTS is a drops per minute. GTT is for drops per minute. So how do you calculate those intravenous drip rate and based on those drops per minute? So let's do one simple example. So the calculation of intravenous drip rates can be done by using volume in milliliters and time per minute. And then drop factor. Drop factors will be given to you, and you will be given volume and time per minute, and then you can calculate flow rate in drops per minute, or that is also known as drips rate. So this is a very standard formula to calculate this drips rates. To understand better, let's take one best example how to calculate them. Calculate the IV flow rate for 250 mL of 0.5 dextrose to be infused over 3 hours. The infusion set has a drop factor for 30 drops per mil. So let's do step one. First, given to you, what is given to you in this question? So given is volume, that is 250 mL, which is given here, 250 mL. And the time that is infused was for 3 hours. And then you have a drop factor that was about 30 drops per mil. So these three are given. And the step two, since the time is given per hours, whereas the calculation required in per minute, so therefore we need to convert that 3 hours to into minutes. To do that one, 3 hours, each 1 hour has 60 minutes. So 3 hours will have 180 minutes. So once you know that 180 minutes time, Now you can plug into the formula, which is volume per mil and time per minute and draw factor. And that draw factor is given in drops per mil, and then you will get flow rate drops per mil. So to get that one, here you just plug in those numbers. You have a 250 mils over 180 minutes, and that is 30 drops per mil, which is mils, mils cancels out, and now you will have total 42 drops per minute. So this is what exactly the way to calculate for drops per minute. Let's take another example for IV flow rate. IV flow rates are measured in mils per hour. Like in 1 hour, how many mils of IV was infused? To calculate that, you need to use this formula. For example, calculation of flow rate for infusion pump is done by volumes in milliliters over time is given per hour. And that gives you flow rate per mil per hour. Because infusion pumps, they don't use the drops per mil. So here, only difference is here, there is no drops per mil or drip rate. So therefore, that gives you straightly, if you divide volume over time, that gives you flow rate mils per hour. Let's take an example of a case. So 1 liter of normal saline was infused into a frail patient for 10 hours. How many mils of normal saline will be infused every 1 hour? So step one, determine what is given to you. So you are given 1 liter volume and time is 10 hours. So the second step is the 1 liter have to be changed into the milliliters. To do that one, you can set up the dimension analysis. 1 liter equals 1,000 multiplied with 1,000 milliliters per hour. So you will get liter cancel, and then you have 1,000 milliliters. So 1 liter is equals to 1,000 milliliter. Now step three, you can plug into the IV flow rate formula, which is volume in mils, time have to be per hour, and then, sorry, this have to be, time is per hour. And in this case, this is the hours, not the minutes. So you calculate them, it gives you mils per hour. So you have 1,000 mils for 10 hours, which is given to you, and then it gives you 100 mils per hour. So these are the a few examples that helps you to practice in faster and accurate way. And to get more examples or more practice of this type of calculation, stay tuned and subscribe Pharmacy Prep channel and give a big thumbs up. Thank you.